Oh yeah. Feels good.
Are you okay?
Sushi bowl.
Ew! Gross. It's your boy Dante Black, y'all.
It's Songbird.
And we're back for another episode of your favorite internet show, Polar Opposites, the Melanin Edition, in the remote location.
Remote location.
I don't know.
Yeah, shout out to the people out there in Philly, man. Appreciate y'all. Sushi bowl all day.
All right, guys, if this is your first time tuning in, what's up? Make sure you hit that like and that subscribe button so that you're notified when we have new episodes to come up. And just hit that notification bell. Just hit it one time so that you're notified every time the episode comes up, not two times, so that it'll sometime ring to let you know. And it don't sound like ding-a-ling-a-ling. And I got a cold, y'all. I don't know. I'm coming down with something. Got it from some. No, I'm kidding. But no.
Yeah, sure for you.
The weather's changing and it's bothering me. But that's neither here nor there. And if you are a returning opposite fam,
they do.
Thanks for tuning in. And let's get into today's topic. Why do females prefer guys that treat them badly but don't want guys that treat them right? You want to go ahead? Since you already started, you go eat.
They dumb, man. But you can tell. You can always tell that that's what females. Females say they want a good guy, but they don't want a good guy. They don't.
Let me go back and rephrase that. Some.
The majority of females. Majority of females in our tax bracket, they say that they want. Now, I do want to throw this disclaimer out. When I talk about it, I'm not talking about every female. So I can only speak about what's in my tax bracket. So if you outside of my tax bracket, baby, I ain't talking. I'm talking to people that's in my tax bracket. If your primary source to buy groceries is Walmart, I'm talking to you. You in my tax bracket. You in my tax bracket. So.
But what about the ones that shop at Publix and Aldi and Save-A-Lot?
Well, some of y'all still in my tax bracket because y'all shopping over there because y'all got a little extra stamps. So now y'all think y'all high class. Nah, dude, you still Walmart. Don't fucking play with me. Still Walmart. Your basket over there at Publix don't look like your basket be at Walmart. Act right. So, nah, man, hell nah. Salud.
De nada. Not a text you the wrong time.
But thank you. Yeah, females, they want the bad guy because it's fun. It's exciting, you know.
It's fun and exciting for a while, but then once you sitting there because he done broke y'all date for the third time this week, and he with two other girls, the times that he broke that date with you, and you somewhere crying, then you gonna be like, dang, I should have just went with the nerdy dude or the dude that. Actually asked me out on a date, wanted to know what my likes and dislikes were, wanted to, you know, be in a relationship exclusively with just me.
Nah, cause let me tell you what happened. When y'all get them nice guys, you know, they hit you in the phone like, good morning, how you doing? You know, I want to know what's your favorite color and all that. Let me tell you what y'all females be doing, because I hear it happen all the time. Girl, he asked me what my favorite color, what the fuck is this? Like, what type of gay ass shit is this? You know my color, like this. This is 2018. Like nobody don't ask that shit no more. Like,
oh,
man, this is
me.
This is man. Come on, what's up with this dude, man? Whatever, man. Don't even respond. Girl, don't respond. Yeah, don't respond. I ain't finna respond to that. That's that old childish stuff. And then the other dude, the hood dude, here though, yo.
What that mouth do?
That WYA. Oh, I'm chilling. Man, you trying to slide, smoke some, gas on deck. Girl, he trying to smoke some. He always got this, he always got that. I'm finna go over there, I'm finna do this, I'm finna do that. And you leave the homeboy who generally is trying to get to know you, you leave him on red. Because he ain't popping. He ain't popping at all. But the dude who's so-called popping, he just trying to get in your panties. But y'all give hell to the nice guy when he trying to get to know you. oh, you only just trying to get one thing. Like, you come at the guys that you're not supposed to come at like that. So we take guy A, that's the good guy, guy B. You come at guy A the way you should be coming at guy B. But your the way you treat them is in reverse. The roles are reversed.
That's true.
And y'all don't want the nice guy. Y'all say y'all want it. Now, a lot of females, they say they want that nice guy. They want the guy to pull out chairs. But y'all see that shit is soft.
Well, I'll say this. A lot of females want that nice guy. Once they've been ran through, they done went through all the dudes in the neighborhood. Now you want a good guy. If you done had about four kids, you 25, 26, oh, I just want to settle down and get married. But you got four kids with three baby daddies. Nobody wants that.
Nobody wants that.
Sorry.
And listen, and this is from a good guy standpoint, why would you want him to have your tainted pussy? Think about that. If this man did everything he was supposed to do in life, the way he was supposed to do it, and you see him as a prize, but you can throw your pussy around to everybody, why in the fuck should he want you? What are you bringing to him other than a ass load of responsibilities and liabilities?
Did you really just qualify yourself in the good guy standpoint?
No, I didn't say it was me. Okay. I said coming from that standpoint.
Okay.
I didn't say I was a good guy. If I'm the worst dude you ever fucking meet. I'm the type of dude that...
He's worse than the Grinch.
I'm one of them dudes that come to your house, stay at your house, wake up in the middle of the night in just a pair of drawers and eat up all your baby snacks.
Fuckboy status.
That's all me, baby. That's all me. I ain't trying to work. I ain't trying to work. I'm trying to have you take care of me. When you go to work, I need you to give me your car. That's what I'm saying. And then I need you to fill it up because I got shit to do. But when I come back to get you from work late, you got to put some gas in here. It's your responsibility for us to get
home. His nickname is Jody Jr.
Yeah, it's your job to put some gas in. How the fuck we going to get home? And them the type of dudes that females like. They don't want no dude that, oh, he's sending flowers. Because I used to work with this girl. Her dude used to send her flowers, buy her lunch. You know what she used to do? She used to have him order her enough lunch so she could feed her side nigga at work.
Her work husband?
Yeah. When those flowers come in, she have her homegirl sitting on her desk so that her work husband don't know that it's for her. And then when her homegirl go on lunch break, she go put it in the trunk of her car because she finna take her work husband home because he ain't got a car. This dude used to give her his car, his debit card, so that she can buy whatever she need throughout today. Out the day, if he wasn't gonna buy her something, he'd give her the debit card that his check get deposited on. You know what she do? She go buy stuff for her work husband.
I wish.
She fill this nigga car with gas off his paycheck. But when Valentine's Day roll around, she all on social media how she got the best boyfriend in the world. Oh, he treat me like a queen. I'm so blessed to have him. But then when you clock in at work, it's all about this dude. Your boyfriend, he all kind of sauce. He all kind of punks. He all kind of this. He all kind of that. You know, I'm thinking about leaving him. But he take care of you. He take care of your kids.
He take care of your work husband.
Yeah, he take care of all y'all.
My work husband probably like, you better not leave him. He take care of us.
But the work husband don't want you. He just want what's in your panties. And it's the thrill because he popping. He the nigga that's always smelling good. He all clean cut all the time. You know, he got all the little girls in the office wanting him. But he only really fucking with you in your presence. Because on your off days, he fucking with somebody else.
Oh, of course.
And those are the ones that y'all want. Y'all don't want the nice guy. The nice guy is a dream. It looks good on social media. It looks good on social media. And a lot of y'all, and I do want to put this out there, a lot of y'all that got the nice guys, that's doing what they supposed to do, y'all hoes ain't doing what y'all supposed to do to keep them.
You want to say that in the back? You want to say that a little loud for the people in the back?
Y'all hoes ain't doing what y'all supposed to do to keep them. If you know you got a good dude, there's a list of shit that you should be doing. And just bringing your close to mediocre pussy to the table ain't enough.
Oh, Christmas and Valentine's Day.
Exactly. listen, if you got a good dude, he knows he's a good dude.
But that's the thing, though. If you know you have a good person, even if it's something that you know you don't necessarily like doing, but you know they enjoy, you do it anyway. Because you care more about that person than you do about necessarily how you feel about it.
They don't care. So when I say females don't like good dudes, they don't. So, and I'm only speaking about the ones in my tax bracket. You Walmart shoppers, I'm talking about y'all. Save a lot, y'all too. Y'all in there. Everything Walmart
club, so.
That's the bulk version of Walmart. Nigga, you in my tax bracket. Boom.
Nah.
Yeah. Your they tax, owned by the same people.
Your tax bracket.
Sam Walton and Walmart, Walton, whatever. I think they like the same
Walmart,
niggas.
Walmart, Walton?
Whatever them dudes. The white boys that own them both. I think they brothers.
Can somebody tell me who Walmart Walton is?
I don't know them. Walmart Walton. That's what I'm going to call them.
Please put that down in the comments if you can put up a picture of Walmart Walton.
Listen, if y'all ever work for Walmart, y'all know who I'm talking about. It's the white dude. He always wearing a baseball cap. You never see him. I think he died or some shit like that.
Is that Dave Thomas?
What?
Hey,
that's the Wendy's nigga. He ain't never wore a hat. I ain't never seen a picture with a hat.
I ain't never seen a picture of Walmart Walton either, but I mean,
I don't know who the hell these niggas is. I don't own them. I know they family owned, and they won't let you own none of their business. Now that I know.
All right, so if you guys, what was our topic?
You fucking high?
No, I told you I don't feel well. I'm just kind of, well, you got, don't say that. If you have any comments, make sure that you hit us down below in the comments. If you have any topics that we should do, make sure you hit us on our social media.
Somebody hit her down below in her comments. That's why she don't feel well.
All right, y'all. I'm Songbird.